the Meek Geek Gab Show, a regular vlog where I get to yak about news and reviews focused on video games, electronics, sci-fi, fantasy movies, TV shows, comic books, collectibles, and other geeky topics. Oh, hi. Welcome to another episode of the Meek Geek Gab Show, sort of a geeky show where I talk about video games, science fiction movies, comic books, and similar geeky topics. Me and my friends, we went out Friday night, around Friday the 26th, 2012, in the evening, and went out to the Wellington Theatre in London, Ontario, to see Argo. Rated R. Just wanted to give a quick review, or depending on how much we talk about it, maybe a long review. And basically, it is written by Joshuah Bearman from the article Escape from Tehran, and Chris Terrio wrote the screenplay. Ben Affleck stars as Tony Mendez, Bryan Cranston stars as Jack O'Donnell, Alan Arkin stars as Lester Siegel, the incomparable and hilarious John Goodman. I love this actor. He stars as John Chambers. Victor Garber, from London, Ontario, by the way, plays Ken Taylor, Tate Donovan, Bob Anders, Clea Duval as Cora Legic, Scoot McNary as Joe Stafford, as well as scores of other great actors and actresses. The basic plot of the story is that it is a dramatization of the 1980 joint CIA-Canadian secret operation to extract six fugitive American diplomatic personnel out of revolutionary Iran. Oh, hi, this is the Meek Geek, and I went out with my friend Joel, and we went to the Wellington Theater to see Argo, starring Ben Affleck and many other great actors and actresses. So, Joel, what was your impression of the movie?
Oh, it was excellent. You know what I liked about it? At the beginning, they go into a very brief history of Iran.
Mm-hmm.
And the great thing is they acknowledge the fact that the British and the Americans were the assholes who got the ball rolling.
They provoked it.
Well, yeah, they did, because
they had a democratic country at first, didn't
they? In the early 50s, and then the ass-wise the Americans and British reinstalled the Shah of Iran, who was a pile of crap. And they acknowledge the guilt of British and American interests for causing the Iranians to hate the Americans, which of course doesn't justify it, but it was a good history.
Two wrongs don't make a right, obviously.
Obviously, but hey, listen.
Sorry, go ahead.
No, I was going to say is that it was historically accurate.
Yeah,
okay?
And it sort of gives a balanced view. It's not one-sided. It doesn't take sides in the issue. The Iranians were very much wronged by the American industrialists. But at the same token, they toppled over the Shah, who was a very cruel dictator, and they turned out to have a even worse dictator, who was just as cruel. So it's like from out of the frying pan into the fire.
You know what I liked about the movie? I'm gonna tell you from a strictly production point of view.
Yeah.
Holy cow, it was very authentic. The phones, the 1970s phones.
Yeah, it had a nice cars, flavor. The actors were so authentic. I heard Ben Affleck, to an entertainment report, that Ben Affleck actually, when he was directing the movie, had all the actors locked up in stay in a room, and they had magazines, 1970s magazines, to read nothing else from the era, outside the era. The 70s reading material, and they sort of almost became in that mindset. He wanted them to become part of that era, almost programmed them to live in the 70s of time warp. And you could just sense, not they didn't just look 70s, but they acted 70s.
They thought 70s.
It was like
they
a time warp.
70s.
Yeah.
I mean, it really, most of the movie actually takes place in 1980, but let's face it, you know, late 70s, early 80s, basically the same thing. And you know, I remember that unfolding when I was a kid.
Yes.
Because I was always a newsy guy, even when I was a kid.
And a Canadian diplomat, he was considered to be a hero.
Yeah, he ended up being a CIA agent anyway. Yeah. That doesn't matter. But the great thing
he did a good job, though.
The great thing, the wonderful thing that Ben Affleck and all the actors did,
Garber, that plays the agent, the hero,
is they really made the story, the real life, authentic story, come to life in a big way.
Yeah.
Lots of suspense, lots of action.
And it balances the suspense and drama with a lot of lighthearted humor. Like John Goodman and the, who's that director who plays that big production director?
Oh, yeah.
The older guy.
What is his name?
He's an older guy, but he's very funny. Well, Cranston was there. But the real funny part was the movie production with the science fiction theme. And they had a purple Chewbacca. They had some gorgeous half-naked women. And a guy who looked like a C-3PO. They had the... A lot of the, they were rehearsing their lines, and they actually convinced the media that they were making a science fiction movie. That's one of the clever things about the making of this movie, or making the bogus movie, fooling people into thinking it was a movie, because they created a lot of hype through the newspapers and the magazines. They made people think there was actually a science fiction movie going on. That's why one of the reasons why if they were able to get away with it is because of there was advertising promoting this science fiction movie, and they really went gung-ho with it, the script. They needed a desert location in Iran to create the movie.
It's called plausible deniability.
Exactly, and they really took the ball and they ran with it. And what other part? The very, very close, near the end of the movie, you notice that the actors, they went for the authenticity of the characters. I love movies like this because they inspire me. Did you notice in the halfway near the end, they were about to abort the mission, and Ben Affleck's character was... He was saying, "Hell, I am." He just went ahead with it, balls to the wall, and he stuck with it. I found that very inspirational. So, if you have an idea that you wholeheartedly believe in, I mean, within reason,
go for it.
You know,
go for it.
Don't let people discourage you, and it turned out to be a success because they believed in themselves. It was the power of belief, because the odds seemed to be against them. It seemed like everyone was against it. Those security officers, they were really putting the pressure on those. But they just kept on. I liked how, remember the guy with the mustache, one of the hostages originally? The six hostages.
He didn't believe in what they were doing.
Yeah, and he was scared at first, but he overcame his fear.
And that's inspiring. At the end, he was one of the biggest reasons why they got through the security guard.
He put on a good BS about this movie being a science fiction about liberation, and he kind of reached the soldiers' hearts because the soldiers related to that. The idea of liberation from oppressive. So he made it like it was a story about liberation from an oppressive tyrant, and they liked that. And so he appealed to them, and he overcame his fear. And I found that very inspirational personally. And just the idea, whole idea of going with your dream, pursuing your dream, believing in yourself. These are really inspirational themes in the story, and I think everyone who wants to be a feel-good movie should see this movie. Full of thrills, full of action and comedy, and it just gives you a feeling of, you know, believe in yourself, and don't let other people discourage you of your plans. And how many How many spaceships, Argo spaceships, are you going to give this out of five, Joel?
At least a 4.5.
4.5 spaceships?
Maybe five. Yeah. 4.5 to 5. Maybe, you know, wow, it's excellent.
I'm going to give it, I'm going to put myself on a limb, and I'm going to say, I'm going to give it 5 spaceships out of 5.
Yeah.
I really enjoy this movie. If you guys who listen to this YouTube review, if you haven't seen it, see this movie.
You know something? Mm-hmm. One last thing I'm going to say mm-hmm. about this show.
Yeah.
It shows how damn fool stupid a lot of science fiction is.
Yeah.
That's the great thing.
But it was so bad, it was good.
No,
but it makes it. I can understand where you're going.
But you know what? I can honestly say yeah. I'm a recovered Trekkie after that.
Yeah. Well, you get to see the silliness of it, but in this case, the stupid science. In this case, this silly science fiction that they were making turned out to save. It actually saved lives this time.
Yeah, well, yeah,
so
I know.
So we can see the, you know, yeah, it was silly, but it gave me lots of laughs anyway. So
okay,
big fan of the movie. See it. All right, that's all for now. Make sure to like, favorite, subscribe this video. And check out the Meek Video Game blog, www.videogamersoasis.com/blog. And check this video as well on my Video Gamers Oasis Facebook fan page. Like it. And follow me on Twitter, VG_tweets. This is the Meek Geek signing out. Until later. Welcome, YouTubers and gamers alike. I'm the Meek Geek. Welcome to official VGO videos on Represent Asifan Network. This is the YouTube shoutouts, where I get to shout out my favorite channels who have subscribed and have requested shoutouts to be announced for life. Not just once or twice, but for every week. At the end of each week, I will be giving these shoutouts. Before we get on to the YouTube shoutouts, let's get on to some information, announcements here. Representing Asifan Network, check out their YouTube channel. All my official video videos, gaming videos, game-related videos, will be posted on the Meek Geek Video Game blog, www.videogamersoasis.com/blog. Check them out. There's always new stuff there. Here's some Asifan Network news. Asifan runner-up for the Asifan Network editing competition has been announced. Check out the link below. As well, check his channel out and leave some love on his video. As well as the Asifan Network Team Tige 4 editing competition is here. It's up. Here it is. Check out the link below. I will be posting these videos. These videos will be the linked. They'll be linked on this video and below this video as well. Check out the video, write, like, comment, favorite, subscribe. Subscribe and let me know if you want a channel shout-out in my next video. If you would like a YouTube shout-out to your channel, please subscribe to official VGO videos and send me a message requesting a free shout-out. If you already subscribed to my channel and you didn't get a shout-out, by all means, please leave a comment below and ask for a shout-out. I will make sure to respond immediately in the next video with your reward. Now, the YouTube shout-outs are as follows. The main one, and check out his mixtape, www.tweetmymixtape.com/37
O3QV, Ethanator E, Mr. KM Studios, VDJ FRI, SK20089123, Justavari, Karnat 1997, Fearless 2000 HD, Megzers 96, Pay Network, The Real Gamers 3DX, Technology with Chris. Check out his website, technologywithchris.wix.com/info. Ali the Kid 06, Guitar Show Player, Bark Nur Z, Floss Studio, X Chill Gaming X, Whale Z Sum, Liam Pugs, The Gamer Badger, NES Rockman 1987, Rowan Bernardo, Items Craft, Mackensaw, and check out his website, the underscore mast underscore vigilante slash index slash, and that's, you can look that on his website, specifically www.lowercasew11.zetaboards.com/. So the rest of it is the underscore mast underscore vigilante slash index slash. Crayon Eating Ninja, Xerathez, The Poseidon Rocks 1, IBZ Shady, BMX is Wicked, capital TTHP, lowercase ASCUAGON, Kayla is Made of Awesome, American Clue, Frapper Mac, Amanda Lamb Music, A Delta Production, TOAJEDIHOHLIT, Deltas Graphics, or GFX, Magazine Gap, Kleiner Pushel, capital HH, Hey David 17, Funny Zelda Boy, I Fever CIINEMA, I Fever Sima Nima, I believe that's how it's pronounced. OZINTHI MEIO Unity, Male Unity, The Jacks, that's THEJAGXS, Bring the Storm, and finally GREQ111. Please subscribe to these channels and check out their videos. If you would like a YouTube shoutout, all you have to do is subscribe to Official Video Videos on YouTube and ask for a shoutout. That's all you have to do. It's not that hard. Just push the button, boop, and ask for a shoutout. Instant results. If you already subscribed to my channel and you didn't get a shoutout, please, by all means, please leave a comment below. Ask for a shoutout. I will make sure to respond immediately in the next video with your reward. Now it's time for the Official Video Videos YouTube shoutout question of the week. And last time, the question of the week was, so far, in your opinion, what has been the best PS3 game of 2012? Mackensaw, who's already getting YouTube shoutouts for life, but I really appreciate his answer and his diligence in answering. In my opinion, he said, the best PS3 game of 2012 will be Assassin's Creed 3, which comes out in November. Thank you very much, Mackensaw, and I will continue to just shout out your channel and keep letting you be known that you're a very helpful contributor to the YouTube shoutouts. Official Video Videos YouTube shoutout question of the week, this time, is Minecraft players, okay? All you Minecraft players, please listen up. What are some of your best creations? Show me some examples. Leave video comments below this video, and I will make sure to include some links to your videos. I'll promote your videos in the video and underneath the video description. All answers to this question will be rewarded with YouTube shoutouts to their channel in every future video for life. I'm the Meek Geek, owner of Official Video Videos, representing Aspen Network. Enjoy the rest of the show.